السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى واستعين به واستغفره واستهديه، وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to accept from all of us our good deeds, Ya Rahman Rahimeen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to empower us and to increase our iman and our Islam. Ameen, Ya Rahman Rahimeen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. These days, Muslims around the world, they are celebrating or they are remembering Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, which is that today is the night of the 27th of Rajab. But to be honest, there is no authentic hadith saying that Al-Isra al-Mi'raj, it was in the 27th of Rajab. It was in the month of Rajab. But 27th, there is no authentic hadith saying that. Anyway, we believe in these two journeys of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because it is in the Holy Quran, both of them, the two journeys of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The ground one from Al-Masjid Al-Haram, Mecca to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa at Jerusalem. And second journey, it was from Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa up to the seven heavens, up to the Sidrat Al-Muntah. It was in the part of the night. While during that time, just to go to Jerusalem, to come to Mecca in 40 days round trip. It was in just part of the night. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came back while his bed was warm, like what the scholar said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Isra, سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلَهُ لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. The Surah Al-Isra started with purification, glorifying Allah's name. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a proof. And you have the surah, Surah Al-Isra. Subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Isra al-Nabi from Al-Masjid al-Haram to Al-Masjid al-Aqsa. And you have also a proof from the Quran for second journey, which is Al-Mi'raj. From Al-Masjid al-Aqsa up to the Sidrat al-Muntaha, up to the seven heavens, up to Sidrat al-Muntaha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about this rihla al-samawiyya. وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ Surah Al-Najm. وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ means Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw angel Jibreel twice as Jibreel, not as a human being, as Jibreel with 600 wings blocking the horizon. And he saw him for second time at, like what Allah said, وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ نَزْلَةً أُخْرَى for second time, where? عِنْدَ سِدْرَةِ الْمُنْتَهَى at سِدْرَةِ الْمُنْتَهَى. Where is سِدْرَةِ الْمُنْتَهَى? And what is سِدْرَةِ الْمُنْتَهَى? سِدْرَةِ الْمُنْتَهَى, it is a tree. Its leaves big like the ears of the elephants. And its fruits like qilal hajar, big fruits. Well, Sidrat al-Muntaha, close to Jannat al-Ma'wa, mashallah. How many Jannah we have? We have Jannat al-Firdaus al-A'la, the highest Jannat al-Mulk, Jannat al-Khuld, Jannat al-Salam, Jannat Adan, Jannat al-Ma'wa. عند سدرة المنتهى عندها جنة المأوى إذ يغشى السدرة ما يغشى ما زاغ البصر وما طغى لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى. It was not a dream. Like what they said, Rasulullah was not there by only his soul, like what they said, no, by his soul, spirit and his body. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Why? Because Allah said in Surah Al-Isra, سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. عبده means what? His body, physical body. And his soul, both of them, laylan, at night. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, and this is a proof from the Quran, tayyib, what was the situation or the conditions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 1 year before the two journeys of Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj? Look what happened to him alayhi salatu wa salam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was planting the seeds or putting the seeds of da'wah in Mecca for 13 years, as you know. During that time or the year before the two journeys of Al-Isra al-Mi'raj, Abu Talib, the uncle of Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who used to defend him outside Mecca, died. And also in the same year, His wife, beloved wife, أم المؤمنين, the mothers of the believers, خديجة, died. While خديجة used to defend رسول الله inside مكة. يبقى no defense بقى outside or inside. What happened to him, صلى الله عليه وسلم? They drove him out of مكة. You cannot stay with us here. أبو طالب died, خديجة died, that's it. Nobody has, يعني, there for him, عليه الصلاة والسلام, except Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Did he said, and he said, خلاص, this is what I did, my job? No. عليه الصلاة والسلام. He went to الطائف. الطائف one of the biggest cities, Mecca and the Taif. That's why the infidels or the kuffar of Quraysh during the time, they never denied the Quran al-Kareem. They knew the Quran is true from Allah. But they denied Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. While they used to trust him, they used to love him, but since he came with لا إله إلا الله, they stand against him. قالوا لولا نزل هذا القرآن على رجل من القريتين عظيم. إحنا we don't have any problem with the Quran, but the problem is محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. They used to call him sometimes يتيم أبو طالب, the orphan of أبو طالب. They used to belittle him عليه الصلاة والسلام, and they used to give him a name, the son of أبي كبشة. أبي كبشة the husband of حليمة السعدية, the breastfeeding lady of رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. Somehow they said, no, if this Quran is Allah revealed it to one of the great people, any great man like chief or rich man or a strong man, in الطائف, القريتين means the طائف and مكة, عظيم, great man, it's okay, we can accept it. Muhammad, no, عليه الصلاة والسلام. This is what happened. They drove him out of Mecca. He went to الطائف to plant this another seed of Dawah there. I will not just sit like this. And he went there for 40 days. Making da'wah individually, openly, secretly, nobody accepted him at all, alayhi salatu wasalam. See, his Rasulullah, the most beloved to Rasulullah, to Allah Azza wa Jal, nobody accepted him, they challenged him. Not just that, they were standing two lines, after they drove him out from Taif, two lines like this, subhanAllah, with stones, little, very sharp stones there. And they used to throw him with these stones, they used to stone him, alayhi salatu wasalam. All the blood was coming out from his body and his alayhi salatu wasalam. 50 kilometers from Jamrat al-Aqaba, Taif to Jamrat al-Aqaba, Jamrat al-Aqaba where you stone Iblis, when you go to Hajj, to that area, 50 kilometers from Taif to that area, Rasulullah was walking and the blood comes out from his body, alayhi salatu wasalam. That's why Aisha, Umm al-Mu'mineen, she said, Ya Rasulullah, what was the worst day in your life after the battle of Uhud? When 70 of the Sahaba being died as a shaheed, including Hamza, the uncle of Rasulullah, he said, the worst day in my life, Ya Aisha, عندما أخرجني قومك, when the people of Taif, they drove me out of Taif. It was the worst day in my life. He was crying, tearing, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. While he was doing that, cloud was covering him, Jibreel alayhi salam came to him with the angel of the mountain. Ya Muhammad, Allah sent me to you with the angel of the mountains just under your command. Whatever you want, he can do it for you. The angel said, Salamu alayka ya Rasulullah. I come to you by the permission of Allah. If you want me now to destroy Mecca completely with the two al-akhshabayni, two big mountains around Mecca, I will do it. Did Rasulullah say, yes, please do it. I have revenge. I hate these people. No. He said, might be Allah will bring from their descendants, somebody will say, La ilaha illallah. And it was who? Akrima, the son of who? Abu Jahl. Khalid ibn al-Walid, the son of who? Al-Walid ibn al-Mughira. Kuffar, they were against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Their children, descendants, they became Sahaba. See? For that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, might be Allah will bring somebody, will say, La ilaha illallah. Subhanallah. For this is how the situation was there during that time. While his companions, they drove them out from Mecca before that twice to Abyssinia, to Al-Habasha, Ethiopia now. They drove them out and they migrated twice to Abyssinia. And Rasul was not able to defend even himself or them. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came back. Long story short, there are too many details in between. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah said, Ya Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam, nobody accepted you on earth. We're going to open the doors of the sky for you, the heavens for you. Come to me. I will show you the miracles. I will take you to the place nobody can be there.
ابن موسى عليه السلام، ابن إبراهيم عليه السلام. And سبحان الله، the two journeys started. جبريل عليه السلام with the براق, that animal. And سبحان الله, its size less than the donkey. And yeah, سبحان الله, like the mule. And like what I said, it was white, very fast. جبريل عليه السلام, he came to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا رسول الله, I have a choice for you. You have to choose something for of this. He gave him خمر, alcohol, wine, and milk. Choose. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he chooses the milk. I said, you choose الفطرة يا محمد. If you choose الخمر, your ummah will be misguided. عليه الصلاة والسلام. What happened is, he went to المسجد الأقصى, and all the أنبياء from Adam عليه السلام until عيسى عليه السلام, they were waiting for Rasulullah at المسجد الأقصى, standing waiting for him عليه الصلاة والسلام. Rasulullah was very shy. He said, I'm going to see Adam, Musa, Ibrahim for first time in my life. I'm going to see the Anbiya. And he was standing in the back. And Jibreel alayhi salam said, come ya Muhammad, they are waiting for you. And he gave him the banner. What's the banner? The banner of Tawheed. You are the leader of them. Alayhi salatu wasalam. You are the final of them. You are the master of them. You are the imam of them. Come ya Rasulullah. And the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم was leading the salah, and he prayed two rak'ah with him. Two rak'ah, Allah, two rak'ah, ya Shaykh, the salah comes after that. Two rak'ah zahiyan, how? He used to pray صلى الله عليه وسلم like the prayer of Prophet Ibrahim. Two rak'ahs, units, in the beginning of the day, two rak'ah in the end of the day. But how? We don't have any kayfiyya how for these two rak'ahs. But we, there is a hadith comes with that. Anyway, he finished with the Anbiya, then he will start going for second journey, which is Al-Mi'raj. Al-Mi'raj going up. طب العروج is not in the straight, يعني المستقيم, like one line like this. No, this is not Mi'raj. Cannot be like this. Go ask the people of NASA, they're going to tell you. العروج, like what the Quran said, العروج, you have to go like that. This is العروج, up like that. And you have to go from certain place, not any place from earth, you can go up. That's why NASA people, they knew that. There is a door or certain doors they can go up through it. And who said that? Quran said that. Aywa, Quran mentioned this. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. وَلَوْ فَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَابًا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ لَظَلُّوا فِيهِ يَعْرُجُونَ. Allah said in the Quran, if we open a door in the sky for them, they will go through that door up. Even not any place, they cannot just go up like this to the sky. No, they cannot. فالله سبحانه وتعالى already told them in the Quran that. Yeah, there is a certain place, and they know it. NASA people, they know where is it. Subhanallah. Al-Uruj is not, people they think Rasul was going up, straight line. No. Al-Uruj is like this. Subhanallah. This is how it was. Subhanallah, anyway, they went there. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, first heaven, he saw Adam alayhi salam, because he was the first. That's why he must be in the first heaven. Adam alayhi salam, alaykum, alaykum salam. Taban, before he goes up, Jibreel alayhi salam, like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَفُتِحَتِ السَّمَاءُ فَكَانَتْ أَبْوَابَ. The sky has doors. أبوابا. Quran said that in Surah Al-Naba. كانت أبواب. فسيدنا جبريل, he used to knock the door of the heavens. And you have to learn from that. What can we learn? To take permission before you go to anybody. You have to knock the door first. Subhanallah. The angel used to say, who is this? He said, I'm Jibreel. See? I'm Jibreel. Well, he was القوي الأمين. The strongest of the Malaika. I am Jibreel. Oh, are you alone? No, I'm not alone. I am with Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Did Allah send to him? Yes, he's with me. Welcome. Please welcome Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. First heaven, he saw Adam. Adam welcomed Rasulullah. Marhaban bil Nabi Salih. Wal Ibn Salih, my son. Pious son, pious Nabi. And after that, they go second heaven. The same thing, Jibreel alayhi salam, he said, I'll knock the door for each heaven. And he used to take the permission. The same thing. And he found Isa alayhi salam and Yahya, the two cousins. Yahya and Isa, Ibn al-Khala. Subhanallah. And why Isa, second heaven? Because he was before Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. The Rasul comes after him. And number three, Yusuf alayhi salam. And he will come to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And we will enter Jannah, all of us, inshallah, with the beauty of Yusuf alayhi salam. Allah gave him himself 50% of the beauty, shatr, half of the beauty, Isa alayhi salam, Yusuf alayhi salam. And the when he went to the heaven number four, fourth heaven, he found Idris, Nabi Idris. As you know, Idris alayhi salam, he did not die on earth. Idris used to live in Egypt. He lived just only 120 years. He was a big mujahid, big scholar. Subhanallah. And Allah said in Surah Maryam, وَرَفَعْنَاهُ مَكَانًا عَلِيًّا. Allah raised him up. Jibril alayhi salam, Idris was telling him, how many years are you going to live? He said, maybe 120. He said, this is not too long. People they, during that time, they used to live 1,900. Adam himself, 1,000. Sayyidina Nuh, 1,050. Subhanallah. And during that time, Idris, subhanallah, even he was before Nuh. How can you live 120? This is nothing. And they said, you are a scholar, you're a alim, you're a mujahid, you're mashallah. I said, let me go to Allah and ask him to give you more life. And they went there. I was riding the above his back. And long story short, when they reached the fourth heaven, he saw the angel of death. He said, where are you going? He said, I'm very surprised. I get ordered to take somebody's soul here. And I don't know how he can come here. He said, who? He said, Idris. He said, yeah, he's riding my back. Subhanallah, he's going to his death. Subhanallah. That's why Allah said, وَرَفَعْنَاهُ مَكَانًا عَلِيًّا. He's in the fourth heaven. Also, Sayyidina Harun, Aaron, in the fifth heaven. Who is in the sixth heaven? They will come, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of them. Sayyidina Musa. And Musa and Harun, they are brothers. But Musa higher than Harun. Musa alayhi salam was a messenger. And Harun, his brother, was a messenger too. And but Musa better than Harun. That's why he's in the sixth heaven. All of them, they still come, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, he is in the seventh heaven at Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur. What is Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur? Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur, it's exactly like Mecca, Al-Ka'bah in Mecca. Like Al-Masjid Al-Haram. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you take a straight line from Mecca, Al-Ka'bah, up to the seventh heaven, you're going to see Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur. If it will fall down above Al-Ka'bah here on earth. Why Sayyidina Ibrahim is sitting there? Because he built a house for Allah on earth. And Allah said, Al-Jaza' min jins al-amal. This is your reward. You make a house for Allah on earth, I will make a house for you there. As Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur, it's like Al-Ka'bah. 70,000 angels every day, they enter, they never come until the day of judgment. It means every day different 70,000 angels. 70,000 angels. Subhanallah. Sayyidina Ibrahim, he's there with those kids who died while they were infant. Subhanallah. Let's come to the very important hadith before the time is running from me. Yes, the hadith is salah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he being gifted this salah, and Allah gave it to him up to the seventh heaven. He came with 50 salah. That hadith, jama'ah, it's very authentic, because some people nowadays, they are trying to put Muslims in doubt about this hadith. He said, one of the brothers was asking me, Sheikh, it was not a bazaar between Allah and the Sayyidina, Rasulullah and Sayyidina Musa. If Allah say word, khalas. I told him, brother, this authentic hadith, very authentic hadith. And we can learn too many things from this hadith. Rasulullah better than Musa alayhi salam, but he accepted the advice from him. Musa alayhi salam, he had experience during that time more than Rasulullah with Bani Israel. Rasulullah, he asked him, what did Allah give you? When Rasulullah came back, he said, he gave me 50 salah, day and night. He said, I have experience, you're my brother, ya Rasulullah. I have experience with Bani Israel. They're going to give you a hard time. Your people, they will not pray 50 times a day and night. Now they are not praying even 5. What about 50? Yes. And they said, go ask Allah to reduce it. And between Allah and Sayyidina Musa, like 5 every time, until he made it 5 salawat day and night. And Sayyidina Musa said, go ask Allah more to reduce it, to eliminate it for you. And Rasulullah said, no, I am shy now. I'm very shy. I cannot go anymore. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I will not change my word. You're going to pray 5 as the reward I give it to you as if you pray 50. How many hasana? For if you make one hasana, Allah multiply it to 10, right? 5 salawat time 10, huh? 50, as if you pray 50. And Allah said, مَا يُبَدَّلُ الْقَوْلُ لَدَيْكَ. This is out of Allah's mercy. But the point here is, we have to believe it, that happened. That happened for a reason. And you can accept the advice from somebody lower than you. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam better than Musa alayhi salam. Of course, Allah said, وَلَقَدْ فَضَّلْنَا بَعْدَ النَّبِيِّينَ عَلَى بَعْضٍ مِنْهُمْ مَنْ كَلَّمَ اللَّهِ Subhanallah. The point here is, accept if the advice is good, accept it even from somebody, even if you have knowledge more than him. Like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We can learn from al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, al-Durus al-Mustafada, Zikr Allah is very important. Surah al-Isra started with the tasbih. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he gets some advices. He saw the people of Jannah. He saw the people of hellfire. He was about to get a bunch of grapes for Sahaba, but the angel, they said, not yet, Ya Muhammad. It's not yet, not yet. Subhanallah. صلى الله عليه وسلم, he saw Jannah with its people. He saw the hellfire with its people, صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he told us too many things. Like, for example, he saw in his journey, I saw group of people. They have very fresh meat, beautiful meat. And they have filthy, rotten meat. And they left the good one and they are eating from the filthy one. They asked him, what is this, Ya Rasulullah? He said, those who are doing haram, they leave their wives and they go do haram with another woman. Yeah, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that. He gave example. For example, also al-Malaika. When he used to pass by al-Malaika, they used to tell him, Ya Muhammad, ask ummatuk. Ask your ummah to do al-hijama, the cupping. Al-hijama. It's a shifa. Each group of the Sahaba, they used to give him that advice. Ya Rasulullah, let your ummah make the hijama. Cupping. Even Sayyidina Jibreel, he said that. The cure of your ummah in three things. Al-hijama, the cupping. And second one, sharbat asal, to drink some tea, some honey. Yes, pure honey. And wakaya binar with the fire. And they said, I don't like it because Allah punishes people with the fire. The only one who can punish. Also, we can learn that is zikr Allah. Allah started the surah with Subhana alladhi. Tasbih, dhikr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhikr Allah is very important. We can learn also sharaf al-ubudiyya. Alladhi asra bi'abidihi. To be a servant and abd and a slave of Allah. It's a big honor. Yeah, if you will be a slave of somebody like you, this is humiliation. This is not good. But to be a slave of Allah, big honor. Like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah called Rasulullah bi'abdihi, not bi'rasulihi, or his messenger, or nabi, no, bi'abdihi. Also, al-Isra' wal-Mi'raj, the two journeys, both of them, they were by the body and the soul of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, al-Tamkeen, wal-Nasr, wal-Ta'yid, li'ibadillah al-Mukhlaseen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you victorious and strong if you will be sincere and a good Muslim and a good mu'min to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الاطلاع على قدرة الله. الله رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he saw too many of Allah's miracles. لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى. يا جماعة, our earth and our sun is going from here to San Francisco and coming back. It's nothing. This is the same earth for the same sun. You know, but we have too many galaxies, millions of galaxies, millions of suns and moons. Subhanallah, bigger than this, too many times. Rasulullah, he saw all of this. Nobody can go to that level except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is just in our heaven and our sky. But Rasulullah, he goes beyond that. He went back. He went to up to the seven heavens, up to the Sidrat al-Muntaha, to Al-Arsh. There is a weak hadith, but just the time is going very fast. At-tashahud, you know at-tashahud? At-tahiyyatu lillah? This is how Allah meet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I know it's a weak hadith, but we can say it. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he went up to Sidrat al-Muntaha, Jibreel said, this is my limit. If I go more, Allah will burn my light with his light. This is my limit, Ya Muhammad. You can go through, I cannot. Jibreel alayhi salam. And Rasulullah, when he entered to Hadrat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he say? At-tahiyyatu lillah. Was-salawatu wa tayyibat. Allah said, as-salamu alayka ayyuhal nabi wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ah. And the Rasul said, As-salamu alayna wa al-ibadillah as-salihin. He remember you when he was there. Al-Malaika, they answered, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasul. And the Malaika, they start making the drood. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallayta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Wabarik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim fil alameen innaka hamidun majid. See, brothers, we have to know that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the importance of al-Masjid al-Aqsa. المسجد الأقصى الإسلام equal to المسجد الحرام and المسجد النبوي. ولا تشد الرحال إلا لثلاث. If you want to make a long trip for certain مساجد, just only this مساجد. المسجد الحرام مكة, المسجد النبوي المدينة, and المسجد الأقصى. For the importance of المسجد الأقصى for Muslims, رسول الله he was the imam of the أنبياء there, means Allah gave him the banner. المسجد الأقصى belong to the مسلمين. We have to know that. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he saw the أنبياء, and when he came back, he described them, some of them, to the Sahaba. For example, he said, Isa ibn Maryam, Isa alayhi salam, he looks like Urwa ibn Mas'ud. One of the Sahaba, his name is Urwa ibn Mas'ud. If you look at Urwa, he's Isa alayhi salam. And he described Sayyidina Musa too. He said, Musa alayhi salam, he was khafif al-lahm mamshuk. He was not fat, very tall. his strong muscles, so مستدق, and his hair is like curly hair, subhanallah. And he, his skin was brown. He used to live in Upper Egypt, طبعاً, of course. He was brown. This is Musa عليه السلام. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, he described some of the Anbiya to the Sahaba. أصل الدين واحد. The deen of Islam is one deen, one religion. From Adam to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. الإسلام دين الفطرة. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he chooses the milk and he drink it. That's why our Islam is deen الفطرة. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, he went from the level of علم اليقين, just the knowledge, to عين اليقين, to حق اليقين. He saw الجنة, النار, ملائكة, the عرش of Allah. He saw too many things. لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى. رأى means the vision. He saw it, which is the حق يقين. He became certain. That's why رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم is talking also about the importance of the salah in Islam. If you love your salah, if you're not praying, brothers, you're leaving your deen. Between us and non-Muslim people is salah. If you leave it, you leave your deen. That's it. You're out. Some scholars, they said, you're out completely. Some of them, they said, you're still Muslim, but you're making major sin. And some of them, they said, you're kafir or not. And kufr amal wal aqadi. Where you put yourself in the gray area? Pray. Guard your salah. Salah is the main thing in Islam. And the first thing you will be asked about in the day of judgment is salah. If your salah is perfect and complete, enjoy. The rest will be easy for you. If salah, you have problem with the salah, the prayer, brothers, your family, your kids, you yourself, salah, be a role model for your family. الثبات على الحق, and be away from any kind of فواحش, shameful acts like الزنا والربا, الخمر, الحرام, all of these, رسول الله. So too many things, there is no time to continue all of this. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya رب العالمين, أن يتقبل منا وإياكم صالح الأعمال. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واسترنا واجبرنا وعافنا واعف عنا واشف من كان منا مريدا يا رب العالمين, وارحمنا وارحم أموات المسلمين, وتب علينا يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون, وسلام على المرسلين, والحمد لله رب العالمين, وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا.